This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Vitamin B12, vitamin B12 or vitamin B12, also called cobalamin, is a water-soluble vitamin that has a key role in the normal functioning of the brain and nervous system, and the formation of red blood cells. It is one of 8 B vitamins. It is involved in the metabolism of every cell of the human body, especially affecting DNA synthesis, fatty acid and amino acid metabolism. No fungi, plants, nor animals including humans are capable of producing vitamin B12. Only bacteria and archaea have the enzymes needed for its synthesis. Proved sources of B12 are animal products, meat, fish, dairy products and supplements. Some research states that certain non-animal products possibly can be a natural source of B12 because of bacterial symbiosis. B12 is the largest and most structurally complicated vitamin and can be produced industrially only through a bacterial fermentation synthesis. This synthetic B12 is used to fortify foods and sold as a dietary supplement. Vitamin B12 consists of a class of chemically related compounds, vitamers, all of which show pharmacological activity. It contains the biochemically rare element cobalt, chemical symbol Co, positioned in the center of a planar tetrapyrrole ring called a Caron ring. The vitamer is produced by bacteria as hydroxocobalamin, but conversion between different forms of the vitamin occurs in the body after consumption. Vitamin B12 was discovered from its relationship to the disease pernicious anemia, an autoimmune disease in which parietal cells of the stomach responsible for secreting intrinsic factor are destroyed. These cells are also responsible for secreting acid in the stomach because intrinsic factor is crucial for the normal absorption of B12. Its lack in the presence of pernicious anemia causes a vitamin B12 deficiency. Many other subtler kinds of vitamin B12 deficiency and their biochemical effects have since been elucidated. Contents 1 Medical uses 11 Dietary reference intake 12 Controversial sources in algae 13 Deficiency 2 sources 21 Animal sources 22 Fortified foods 23 Supplements 231 Non-cyanide forms as supplements 24 Controversial sources 3 Elevated plasma B12 Cobalamin levels 4 Interactions 5 Structure 6 Synthesis and industrial production 7 Mechanism of action 71 Enzyme function 8 Absorption and distribution 9 History 10 See also 11 References 12 External links Medical uses Vitamin B12 is used to treat vitamin B12 deficiency, cyanide poisoning, and hereditary deficiency of transcobalamin 2. It is given as part of the Schilling test for detecting pernicious anemia for cyanide poisoning. A large amount of hydroxocobalamin may be given intravenously and sometimes in combination with sodium thiosulfate. The mechanism of action is straightforward. The hydroxycobalamin hydroxide ligand is displaced by the toxic cyanide ion, and the resulting harmless B12 complex is excreted in urine. In the United States, the Food and Drug Administration approved in 2006 the use of hydroxycobalamin for acute treatment of cyanide poisoning. Dietary reference intake. The Food and Nutrition Board of the U.S. Institute of Medicine updated estimated average requirements years and recommended dietary allowances RDAs for vitamin B12 in 1998. The current year for vitamin B12 for women and men ages 14 and up is 20 micrograms per day. The RDA is 24 micrograms per day. RDAs are higher than years so as to identify amounts that will cover people with higher than average requirements. RDA for pregnancy equals 26 micrograms per day. RDA for lactation equals 28 micrograms per day. For infants up to 12 months, the adequate intake AI is 0.4-0.5 mg per day, and for children ages 1 to 13 years the RDA increases with age from 0.9 to 18 micrograms per day because 10-30% of older people may be unable to effectively absorb vitamin B12 naturally occurring in foods. It is advisable for those older than 50 years to meet their RDA mainly by consuming foods fortified with vitamin B12 or a supplement containing vitamin B12. As for safety, the Food and Nutrition Board of the U.S. Institute of Medicine sets tolerable upper intake levels known as ULs for vitamins and minerals when evidence is sufficient. In the case of vitamin B12 there is no UL, as there is no human data for adverse effects from high doses. The European Food Safety Authority reviewed the same safety question and also reached the conclusion that there was not sufficient evidence to set a UL for vitamin B12 collectively. The ERs, RDAs and ULs are referred to as dietary reference intakes for U.S. food and dietary supplement labeling purposes. The amount in a serving is expressed as A percent of daily value percent DV for vitamin B12 labeling purposes 100% of the daily value was 60 micrograms, but as of May 2016 it has been revised downward to 24 micrograms. A table of the pre-change adult daily values is provided at reference daily intake. Food and supplement companies have until July 2018 to comply with the change. Controversial sources in algae: the UK Vegan Society, the Vegetarian Resource Group, and the Physicians Committee for Responsible Medicine, among others, recommend that vegans either consistently eat B12 fortified foods or take a daily or weekly B12 supplement to meet the recommended intake. It is important for vegans, whose food provides few sources of B12, and anyone else wishing to obtain B12 from food sources other than animals, to consume foods that contain little or no pseudovitamin B12 and are high in biologically active B12. So-called pseudovitamin B12 refers to B12-like analogs that are biologically inactive in humans and yet found to be present alongside B12 in humans. Many food sources, including animals, and possibly supplements and fortified foods in most cyanobacteria, including spirulina, and some algae, such as dried Asakusa nori porphyra tenera, pseudovitamin B12 is found to predominate. There have been no significant human trials of sufficient size to demonstrate enzymatic activity of B12 from non-bacterial sources, such as chlorella and edible sea algae seaweeds. Such as lavers, although chemically some of these sources have been reported to contain B12 that seems chemically similar to the active vitamin deficiency. Main article: vitamin B12 deficiency. Vitamin B12 deficiency can potentially cause severe and irreversible damage, especially to the brain and nervous system at levels only slightly lower than normal. A range of symptoms such as fatigue, depression, and poor memory may be experienced. Vitamin B12 deficiency can also cause symptoms of mania and psychosis. Vitamin B12 deficiency is most commonly caused by low intakes, but can also result from malabsorption, certain intestinal disorders, low presence of binding proteins, and use of certain medications. Vitamin B12 is rare from plant sources, so vegetarians are most likely to suffer from vitamin B12 deficiency. Infants are at a higher risk of vitamin B12 deficiency if they were born to vegetarian mothers. The elderly who have diets with limited meat or animal products are vulnerable populations as well. Vitamin B12 deficiency can manifest itself as anemia in some cases. Deficiency can cause permanent neurological damage. Recent studies show depression is associated with vitamin B12 deficiency. Sufficient vitamin B12 levels are independently associated with a decreased risk of depression and better cognitive performance adjusted for confounders. Vitamin B12 is a co-substrate of various cell reactions involved in methylation synthesis of nucleic acid and neurotransmitters. Synthesis of the trimonoamine neurotransmitters can enhance the effects of a traditional antidepressant. The intracellular concentrations of vitamin B12 can be inferred through the total plasma concentration of homocysteine, which can be converted to methionine through an enzymatic reaction that uses 5-methyl tetrahydrofolate as the methyl donor group. Consequently, the plasma concentration of homocysteine falls as the intracellular concentration of vitamin B12 rises. The active metabolite of vitamin B12 is required for the methylation of homocysteine in the production of methionine, which is involved in a number of biochemical processes including the monoamine neurotransmitter's metabolism. Thus, a deficiency in vitamin B12 may impact the production and function of those neurotransmitters. Sources: animal sources. Vitamin B12 is found in most animal-derived foods, including fish and shellfish, meat especially liver, poultry, eggs, milk, and milk products. The bioavailability from eggs is less than 9%, compared to 40% to 60% from fish, fowl and meat. An NIH fact sheet lists a variety of animal food sources of B12 fortified foods. Foods fortified with B12 are also dietary sources of the vitamin. Foods for which B12 fortified versions are widely available include breakfast cereals, soy products, energy bars, and nutritional yeast. The UK Vegan Society, the Vegetarian Resource Group, and the Physicians Committee for Responsible Medicine, among others, recommend that every vegan who is not consuming adequate B12 from fortified foods take supplements. Reputable manufacturers of fortified foods and dietary supplements include an overage excess in their formulas so that the products still contain the labeled amounts at the end of shelf life. Supplements: hydroxycobalamin injection USP 1000. The tongue has not proven to be necessary or helpful, even though a number of lozenges, pills, and even a lollipop designed for sublingual absorption are being marketed. A 2003 study found no significant difference in absorption for serum levels from oral versus sublingual delivery of O5-phate, and biological distribution of methylcobalamin are expected to be similar to that of other sources of vitamin B12 in the diet. No cyanide is released with methylcobalamin, the amount of cyanide 20. Mortality risk, but a recent study of this found that levated B12 levels are not a significant predictor of mortality after ICU admission when liver function is controlled for, and may instead be a proxy for poor liver function. A second group of non-supplemented patients with high cobalamin levels have them due to enhanced production of the plasma B12 transporters haptocorin and transcobalamin II. This happens in hematologic disorders like chronic myelogenous leukemia, promyelocytic leukemia, polycythemia vera, and also the hyperuricinophilic syndrome. Increased cobalamin levels are one of the diagnostic criteria for the latter two diseases. A third group of non-supplemented patients with high cobalamin levels. Examples: H2 receptor antagonists include cimetidine Tagamet, famotidine Pepcid, nizatidine Axid, and ranitidine Zantac. Reduced secretion of gastric acid and pepsin produced by H2 blockers can reduce absorption of protein-bound dietary vitamin B12, but not of supplemental vitamin B12. Gastric acid is needed to release vitamin B12 from protein for absorption. Clinically significant vitamin B12 deficiency and megaloblastic anemia are unlikely, unless H2 blocker therapy is prolonged 2 years or more, or the person's diet is poor. It is also more likely if the person is rendered a chlorhydric with complete absence of gastric acid secretion, which occurs more frequently with proton pump inhibitors than H2 blockers. Vitamin B12 levels should be monitored in people taking high doses of H2 blockers for prolonged periods. Metformin glucophage. Metformin may reduce serum folic acid and vitamin B12 levels. Long-term use of metformin substantially increases the risk of B12 deficiency, and in those patients who become deficient hyperhomocysteinemia, which is an independent risk factor for cardiovascular disease, especially among individuals with type 2 diabetes. There are also rare reports of megaloblastic anemia in people who have taken metformin for 5 years or more. Reduced serum levels of vitamin B12 occur in up to 30% of people taking metformin chronically. Clinically significant deficiency is not likely to develop if dietary intake of vitamin B12 is adequate. Deficiency can be corrected with vitamin B12 supplements even. If metformin is continued, the metformin-induced malabsorption of vitamin B12 is reversible by oral calcium supplementation. The general clinical significance of metformin upon B12 levels is as yet unknown. Proton pump inhibitors PPIs. The PPIs include omeprazole Prilosec, Losec, lansoprazole Prevacid, ribeprazole Acifex, pantoprazole Protonix, Pantoloc, and esomeprazole Nexium. The reduced secretion of gastric acid and pepsin produced by PPIs can reduce absorption of protein-bound dietary vitamin B12, but not supplemental vitamin B12. Gastric acid is needed to release vitamin B12 from protein for absorption. Reduced vitamin B12 levels may be more common with PPIs than with H2 blockers, because they are more likely to produce achlorhydria. Complete absence of gastric acid secretion. Clinically significant vitamin B12 deficiency is unlikely, unless PPI therapy is prolonged 2 years or more, or dietary vitamin intake is low. Vitamin B12 levels should be monitored in people taking high doses of PPIs for prolonged periods. Structure: B12 is the most chemically complex of all the vitamins. The structure of B12 is based on a Karen ring, which is similar to the porphyrin ring found in heme, chlorophyll, and cytochrome. The central metal ion is cobalt. 4 of the 6 coordination sites are provided by the Karen ring, and a fifth by a dimethylbenzimidazole group. The 6th coordination site, the center of reactivity, is variable, being a cyano group CN, a hydroxyl group O, a methyl group CH3, or a 5-deoxyadenosyl group. Here the C5 atom of the deoxyribose forms the covalent bond with Co, respectively, to yield the 4 B12 forms mentioned below. Historically, the covalent C-Co bond is one of the first examples of carbon-metal bonds to be discovered in biology. The hydrogenases and, by necessity, enzymes associated with cobalt utilization, involve metal-carbon bonds. Vitamin B12 is a generic descriptor name referring to a collection of cobalt and Karen ring molecules which are defined defined by their particular vitamin function in the body. All of the substrate cobalt carin molecules from which B12 is made, must be synthesized by bacteria after this synthesis is complete, except in rare cases, the human body has the ability to convert any form of B12 to an active form, by means of enzymatically removing certain prosthetic chemical groups from the cobalt atom, and replacing them with others. The four forms vitamers of B12 are all deeply red-colored crystals and water solutions, due to the color of the cobalt carin complex. Cyanobalamin is one such form, i.e., vitamer, of B12 because it can be metabolized in the body to an active coenzyme form. The cyanobalamin form of B12 does not occur in nature normally, but is a byproduct of the fact that other forms of B12 are avid binders of cyanide CN, which they pick up in the process of activated charcoal purification of the vitamin after it is made by bacteria in the commercial process, since the cyanobalamin form of B12 is easy to crystallize and is not sensitive to air oxidation. It is typically used as a form of B12 for food additives and in many common multivitamins. Pure cyanobalamin possesses the deep pink color associated with most octahedral cobaltii complexes, and the crystals are well formed and easily grown up to millimeter size. Hydroxocobalamin is another form of B12 commonly encountered in pharmacology, but which is not normally present in the human body. Hydroxocobalamin is sometimes denoted B12. This form of B12 is the form produced by bacteria, and is what is converted to cyanobalamin in the commercial charcoal filtration step of production. Hydroxocobalamin has an avid affinity for cyanide ions and has been used as an antidote to cyanide poisoning. It is supplied typically in water solution for injection. Hydroxocobalamin is thought to be converted to the active enzymic forms of B12 more easily than cyanobalamin, and since it is little more expensive than cyanobalamin, and has longer retention times in the body, has been used for vitamin replacement in situations where added reassurance of activity is desired. Intramuscular administration of hydroxocobalamin is also the preferred treatment for pediatric patients with intrinsic cobalamin metabolic diseases, for vitamin B12 deficient patients with tobacco amblyopia, which is thought to perhaps have a component of cyanide poisoning from cyanide in cigarette smoke, and for treatment of patients with pernicious anemia who have optic neuropathy. Adenosylcobalamin ADB12 and methylcobalamin MEB12 are the two enzymatically active cofactor forms of B12 that naturally occur in the body. Most of the body's reserves are stored as ADB12 in the liver. These are converted to the other methylcobalamin form as needed. Synthesis and industrial production. Neither plants nor animals are independently capable of constructing vitamin B12. Only bacteria and archaea have the enzymes required for its biosynthesis. The total synthesis of B12 was reported by Robert Burns Woodward and Albert Eschenmoser in 1972, and remains one of the classic feats of organic synthesis. Species from the following genera are known to synthesize B12: Acetobacterium, Arabacter, Agrobacterium, Alkaligenes, Azotobacter, Bacillus, Clostridium, Corynebacterium, Flavobacterium, Lactobacillus, Micromonaspora, Mycobacterium, Nocardia, Propionibacterium, Protaminobacter, Proteus, Pseudomonas, Rhizobium, Salmonella, Serratia, Streptomyces, Streptococcus and Xanthomonas. Industrial production of B12 is achieved through fermentation of selected microorganisms. Streptomyces griseus, a bacterium once thought to be a yeast, was the commercial source of vitamin B12 for many years. The species Pseudomonas denitrificans and Propionibacterium freudenreichii subsp. Shermanii are more commonly used today. These are frequently grown under special conditions to enhance yield, and at least one company, Rhône Poulenc of France, which has merged into Sanofi Aventis, used genetically engineered versions of one or both of these species, since a number of species of Propionibacterium produce no exotoxins or endotoxins and are generally regarded as safe, have been granted GRAS status by the Food and Drug Administration of the United States. They are presently the FDA preferred bacterial fermentation organisms for vitamin B12 production. The total world production of vitamin B12 by four companies, the French Sanofi Aventis and three Chinese companies, is said to have been 35 tons in 2008. See cyanobalamin for discussion of the chemical preparation of reduced cobalt vitamin analogs and preparation of physiological forms of the vitamin, such as adenosylcobalamin and methylcobalamin. Mechanism of action. Metabolism of folic acid. The role of vitamin B12 is seen at bottom left. Vitamin B12 functions as a coenzyme, meaning that its presence is required for enzyme catalyzed reactions. Three types of enzymes, isomerases rearrangements in which a hydrogen atom is directly transferred between two adjacent atoms with concomitant exchange of the second substituent, X, which may be a carbon atom with substituents, an oxygen atom of an alcohol, or an amine. These use the adib-12-adenosylcobalamin form of the vitamin methyl transferases. Methyl CH3 group transfers between two molecules. These use MeB-12-methylcobalamin form of the vitamin dehalogenases reactions in which a halogen atom is removed from an organic molecule. Enzymes in this class have not been identified in humans. In humans, two major coenzyme B12-dependent enzyme families corresponding to the first two reaction types are known. These are typified by the following two enzymes. MUT is an isomerase which uses the adib-12 form and reaction type 1 to catalyze a carbon skeleton rearrangement. The X group is COSCOA. MUT's reaction converts MML-CoA to SU-CoA, an important step in the extraction of energy from proteins and fats. For more, see MUT's reaction mechanism. This functionality is lost in vitamin B12 deficiency, and can be measured clinically as an increased methylmalonic acid MMA level. Unfortunately, an elevated MMA, though sensitive to B12 deficiency, is probably overly sensitive, and not all who have it actually have B12 deficiency. For example, MMA is elevated in 90-98% of patients with B12 deficiency. 20-25% of patients over the age of 70 have elevated levels of MMA, yet 25-33% of them do not have B12 deficiency. For this reason, assessment of MMA levels is not routinely recommended in the elderly. There is no gold standard test for B12 deficiency, because as a B12 deficiency occurs, serum values may be maintained while tissue B12 stores become depleted. Therefore, serum B12 values above the cutoff point of deficiency do not necessarily indicate adequate B12 status. The MUT function is necessary for proper myelin synthesis. See mechanism below, and is not affected by folate supplementation. MTR, also known as methionine synthase, is a methyl transferase enzyme, which uses the MeB-12 and reaction type 2 to transfer a methyl group from 5-methyltetrahydrofolate to homocysteine, thereby generating tetrahydrofolate THF and methionine. For more, see MTR's reaction mechanism. This functionality is lost in vitamin B12 deficiency, resulting in an increased homocysteine level and the trapping of folate as 5-methyltetrahydrofolate, from which THF, the active form of folate, cannot be recovered. THF plays an important role in DNA synthesis, so reduced availability of THF results in ineffective production of cells with rapid turnover, in particular red blood cells, and also intestinal wall cells, which are responsible for absorption. THF may be regenerated via MTR or may be obtained from fresh folate in the diet. Thus, all of the DNA synthetic effects of B12 deficiency, including the megaloblastic anemia of pernicious anemia, resolve if sufficient dietary folate is present. Thus, the best known function of B12, that which is involved with DNA synthesis, cell division, and anemia, is actually a facultative function which is mediated by B12 conservation of an active form of folate which is needed for efficient DNA production. Other cobalamin requiring methyl transferase enzymes are also known in bacteria, such as MeH4-MPT, coenzyme M-methyl transferase enzyme function. If folate is present in quantity, then of the two absolutely vitamin B12 dependent enzyme family reactions in humans, the MUT family reactions show the most direct and characteristic secondary effects, focusing on the nervous system. See below. This is because the MTR methyl transferase type reactions are involved in regenerating folate, and thus are less evident when folate is in good supply. Since the late 1990s, folic acid has begun to be added to fortify flour in many countries, so folate deficiency is now more rare. At the same time, since DNA synthetic sensitive tests for anemia and erythrocyte size are routinely done in even simple medical test clinics, so that these folate-mediated biochemical effects are more often directly detected, the MTR-dependent effects of B12 deficiency are becoming apparent, not as anemia due to DNA synthetic problems as they were classically, but now mainly as a simple and less obvious elevation of homocysteine in the blood and urine. Homocysteinuria. This condition may result in long-term damage to arteries and in clotting, stroke, and heart attack, but this effect is difficult to separate from other common processes associated with atherosclerosis and aging. The specific myelin damage resulting from B12 deficiency, even in the presence of adequate Folate and methionine, is more specifically and clearly a vitamin deficiency problem. It has been connected to B12 most directly by reactions related to MUT, which is absolutely required to convert methylmalonyl coenzyme A into succinyl coenzyme A. Failure of this second reaction to occur results in elevated levels of MMA, a myelin destabilizer. Excessive MMA will prevent normal fatty acid synthesis, or it will be incorporated into fatty acid itself rather than normal malonic acid if this abnormal fatty acid subsequently is incorporated into myelin. The resulting myelin will be too fragile, and demyelination will occur, although the precise mechanisms are not known with certainty. The result is subacute combined degeneration of central nervous system and spinal cord. Whatever the cause, it is known that B12 deficiency causes neuropathies, even if folic acid is present in good supply, and therefore anemia is not present. Vitamin B12 dependent MTR reactions may also have neurological effects through an indirect mechanism. Adequate methionine, which, like folate, must otherwise be obtained in the diet, if it is not regenerated from homocysteine by a B12-dependent reaction, is needed to make S-adenosyl methionine SAME, which is in turn necessary for methylation of myelin sheath phospholipids. Although production of SAME is not B12-dependent, help in recycling for provision of one adequate substrate for it. The essential amino acid methionine is assisted by B12. In addition, SAME is involved in the manufacture of certain neurotransmitters, catecholamines, and in brain metabolism. These neurotransmitters are important for maintaining mood, possibly explaining why depression is associated with B12 deficiency. Methylation of the myelin sheath phospholipids may also depend on adequate folate, which in turn is dependent on MTR recycling. Unless ingested in relatively high amounts, absorption and distribution. Methyl B12 is absorbed by two processes. The first is an intestinal mechanism using intrinsic factor, through which 1 to 2 micrograms can be absorbed every few hours. The second is a diffusion process by which approximately 1% of the remainder is absorbed. The human physiology of vitamin B12 is complex, and therefore is prone to mishaps leading to vitamin B12 deficiency. Protein-bound vitamin B12 must be released from the proteins by the action of digestive proteases in both the stomach and small intestine. Gastric acid releases the vitamin from food particles, therefore antacid and acid-blocking medications, especially proton pump inhibitors, may inhibit absorption of B12. In addition, some elderly people produce less stomach acid as they age, thereby increasing their probability of B12 deficiencies. B12 taken in a low solubility, non-chewable supplement pill form may bypass the mouth and stomach and not mix with gastric acids, but acids are not necessary for the absorption of free B12 not bound to protein. Acid is necessary only to recover naturally occurring vitamin B12 from foods. R protein, also known as haptocorin and cobalophilin, is a B12 binding protein that is produced in the salivary glands. It must wait to bind food B12 until B12 has been freed from proteins in food by pepsin in the stomach. B12 then binds to the R protein to avoid degradation of it in the acidic environment of the stomach. This pattern of B12 transfer to a special binding protein secreted in a previous digestive step is repeated once more before absorption. The next binding protein for B12 is intrinsic factor IF, a protein synthesized by gastric parietal cells that is secreted in response to histamine, gastrin and pentagastrin, as well as the presence of food in the duodenum. Proteases digest R proteins and release their bound B12, which then binds to IF, to form a complex IF. B12 must be attached to IF for it to be efficiently absorbed, as receptors on the enterocytes in the terminal ileum of the small bowel only recognize the B12 IF complex. In addition, intrinsic factor protects the vitamin from catabolism by intestinal bacteria. Absorption of food. Vitamin B12 thus requires an intact and functioning stomach, exocrine pancreas, intrinsic factor, and small bowel. Problems with any one of these organs makes a vitamin B12 deficiency possible. Individuals who lack intrinsic factor have a decreased ability to absorb B12. In pernicious anemia, there is a lack of IF due to autoimmune atrophic gastritis, in which antibodies form against parietal cells. Antibodies may alternately form against and bind to IF, inhibiting it from carrying out its B12 protective function due to the complexity. Of B12 absorption, geriatric patients, many of whom are hypoacidic due to reduced parietal cell function, have an increased risk of B12 deficiency. This results in 80-100% excretion of oral doses in the feces versus 30-60% excretion in feces as seen in individuals with adequate if B12 complex is recognized by specialized ileal receptors, it is transported into the portal circulation. The vitamin is then transferred to transcobalamin 2-TC2, B12, which serves as the plasma transporter. Hereditary defects in production of the transcobalamins and their receptors may produce functional deficiencies in B12 and infantile megaloblastic anemia, an abnormal B12-related biochemistry, even in some cases with normal blood B12 levels for the vitamin to serve inside cells. The TC2, B12 complex must bind to a cell receptor, and be endocytosed. The transcobalamin 2 is degraded within a lysosome, and free B12 is finally released into the cytoplasm, where it may be transformed into the proper coenzyme, by certain cellular enzymes. See above. Investigations into the intestinal absorption of B12 point out that the upper limit of absorption per single oral dose, under normal conditions, is about 15. Absorption noted in the first paragraph above, may overwhelm the complex R factor and IGF factor dependent absorption, when oral doses of B12 are very large, 1000 or more microg per dose, as commonly happens in dedicated pill oral B12 supplementation. It is this last fact which allows pernicious anemia and certain other defects in B12 absorption to be treated with oral megadoses of B12, even without any correction of the underlying absorption defects. See the section on supplements above. The total amount of vitamin B12 stored in body is about 2-5. B12 deficiency is the cause of pernicious anemia, an anemic disease that was usually fatal and had unknown etiology when it was first described in medicine. The cure, and B12, were discovered by accident. George Whipple had been doing experiments in which he induced anemia in dogs by bleeding them, and then fed them various foods to observe which diets allowed them fastest recovery from the anemia produced in the process. He discovered that ingesting large amounts of liver seemed to most rapidly cure the anemia of blood loss. Thus, he hypothesized that liver ingestion might treat pernicious anemia. He tried this and reported some signs of success in 1920 after a series of clinical studies. George Richards Minot and William Murphy set out to partly isolate the substance in liver which cured anemia in dogs, and found that it was iron. They also found that an entirely different liver substance cured pernicious anemia in humans, that had no effect on dogs under the conditions. Used the specific factor treatment for pernicious anemia, found in liver juice, had been found by this coincidence. Minot and Murphy reported these experiments in 1926. This was the first real progress with this disease. Despite this discovery, for several years patients were still required to eat large amounts of raw liver or to drink considerable amounts of liver juice. In 1928, the chemist Edwin Cohn prepared a liver extract that was 50-100 times more potent than the natural liver products. The extract was the first workable treatment for the disease. For their initial work in pointing the way to a working treatment, Whipple, Minot, and Murphy shared the 1934 Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine. These events led to discovery of the soluble vitamin, called vitamin B12, from bacterial broths in 1947. While working for the Poultry Science Department at the University of Maryland, Mary Shaw Schorb, in a collaborative project with Carl Fokers from Merck, was provided with a $400 grant to develop the so-called LLD assay for B12. LLD stood for Lactobacillus lactis durner, a strain of bacterium which required LLD factor for growth, which was eventually identified as B12. Schorb and colleagues used the LLD assay to rapidly extract the anti-pernicious anemia factor from liver extracts, and pure B12 was isolated in this way by 1948. With the contributions of chemists Schorb, Carl A. Fokers of the United States, and Alexander R. Todd of Great Britain for this discovery, in 1949 Mary Schorb and Carl Fokers received the Mead Johnson Award from the American Society of Nutritional Sciences. The chemical structure of the molecule was determined by Dorothy Crowfoot Hodgkin and her team in 1956. Based on crystallographic data, eventually, methods of producing the vitamin in large quantities from bacteria cultures were developed in the 1950s, and these led to the modern form of treatment for the disease. See also cobalamide. Cyanobalamin includes discussion of chemistry of preparation of reduced cobalt B12 analogs. Hydroxocobalamin, methylcobalamin. References: Carrot Yamada, Kazuhiro 2013, Chapter 9, Cobalt, Its Role in Health and Disease. In Astrid Siegel, Helmut Siegel and Roland K.O. Siegel, interrelations between essential metal ions and human diseases, metal ions in life sciences, 13 Springer pp. Data from preclinical and clinical studies, new results from the prehospital emergency setting, clinical toxicology 44 supple 1:1-3 doi, 101,815,563,650,600,811,607 PMID. Doi 101,038,283,781 PMID. Experimental Biology and Medicine 226:4-243-270 ISSN. DOI 101136 JNNP 692228. B12 for vitamin B12 deficiency, a systematic review of randomized controlled trials, Family Practice 23:3-279-285 DOI 101093 FAMPRA CML008 PMID. Rosenblatt, D.S., Thomas, J.A. 2007, Late-onset combined homocystinuria and methylmalonic aciduria CBLC and neuropsychiatric disturbance, American Journal of Medical Genetics Part A 143A 20-2430-2434 DOI, 101002, AJMGA 31932 PMID. Carrot Yamada, K., Yamada, Y., Fukuda, M., Yamada, S. 1999, Bioavailability of dried Ossicucinore porphyra tenera as a source of cobalamin vitamin B12, International Journal for Vitamin and Nutrition Research, Internationale Zeitschrift für Vitamin und Ernährungsforschung, Journal International de Vitaminologie et de Nutrition 69:6-412-418 DOI, 101024, 0300-98316-96412 PMID. Koch, J., Betz, D., Verberg, J., Donker, AJM, Stehauer, CDA 2010, Long-term treatment with metformin in patients with type 2 diabetes and risk of vitamin B12 deficiency, randomized placebo-controlled trial, BMJ 340, C2181 DOI, 101136, BMJC 2181 PMC. P. Clinical Aspects, Clinical Science 66:2-113-21 PMID. Carrot Wickramasinghe, SN 1995, Morphology, Biology and Biochemistry of Cobalamin and Folate Deficient Bone Marrow Cells, Baylor's Clinical Hematology 83:441-59 DOI, 101016, SO9503536058021-5 XPMID.